been in their storm.
My name's Brittany Arlett, and 6 months ago, my husband walked out on us. I have a one-year-old and a three-year-old, and for the last 6 months, I've been trying to decide what to do, how to heal, and how to just get on with my life. 2 days after our six-year anniversary, the love of my life decided that he didn't want to have anything to do with us any longer. We were a team. We raced together. We met right after college. We have the same degree. We love exercise and fitness. We lead the youth. And one day he decides that's not exactly what he wants to do anymore. Off he went to lead this new and different life, while I sat and waited, praying, hoping that God would intervene. In the midst of all of that, I found myself trying to figure out what to do. Emotionally, I was a mess. I was scared and lonely and betrayed and angry and heartbroken and fearful for me and for these two boys that I'm left to raise. I figured out real quick, turn to God. And that's what I did, along with friends and family. But my main healing was when I turned to God. And I've always been a Christian, I guess since seventh grade. I can remember being baptized, and I've always been a strong believer and a follower, but I think the difference now and what I've learned about myself over the last 6 months is I like to follow rules, and obeying Christ and obeying God came easy to me. I wanted to please, I want to obey. The difference that I've found in myself in the last 6 months is I've fallen in love with Jesus, and while I've been alone, I guess I found my husband through Christ, and the capacity that Daniel used to fill my life is now something that I'm allowing Christ to fill my life, protecting, providing, loving, rescuing, just everything that I want my husband to do for me, I started to expect Christ to do for me, and man, he has not failed me. Time and time again, I have been scared or alone or crying and just have reached out to Christ and found a verse about him filling the husband role or rescuing or protecting and just sticking to that verse and expecting him to do what he said he would do. And he's done it every time. I guess 6 months into this thing, I never thought I would be where I am now. The boys are so little, 1 and 3, so I don't necessarily think our relationship has changed or grown. They really don't understand what's going on. But I hope in the future that they will feel like they can ask me questions. I am journaling things along the way of my spiritual growth that hopefully when they're old enough to understand that they'll feel comfortable enough to come and ask what exactly happened or how did you get through this? And I would be able to either pull out a letter and show them, you know, let me tell you how I got through it, or sit down and have a spiritual conversation. And hopefully God would open up that door to show them that I tried to do the right thing. And in the right thing, I mean, I think early on when Daniel first left, it was very apparent to me God wanted me to honor my marriage vows. I think when your spouse leaves, it's real easy to get angry, and I was angry, and real easy to want to go and find that in somebody else because I did feel rejection. But instead of that, I found my self-worth and my value in Christ, and just trying to leave the results up to him. And I know when I got married, I made that commitment to God and to Daniel. And right now, I'm honoring it because God has asked me to honor it. And that's hard when the person that you're trying to love doesn't respond and doesn't love you back. but I know God will honor that in some way, and I have no idea what that looks like. One of the verses that I really just replay over and over in my head when I feel anger or fear or uncertainty is Romans 8:28, and that he does everything for good for those that love him. And so when I get scared or angry that why are the boys having to grow up this way, or why do I have to feel so rejected or alone, that in some time schedule, not my own, it will be revealed to me and it will be made good for those that love him. And I want him to know that I do love him as a husband. And I've never done that before. That's something new to me. I've always loved him like a father figure or a god, but not my husband. So that's been really neat to see him fulfill that role in my life, because I've always wondered that verse that says that he, you know, fulfills, he is your husband, we are the bride of Christ. Collectively as a church, I guess I understood it, but not really personally. And now I can personally say that I am the bride of Christ, and I feel it every day. Just talking to him and things that he does for me. And I know that if Daniel returns, we have a lot of work to do. And if he doesn't return, then I know that I've done what God's asked me to do, being faithful until the very end of my marriage, and I will be blessed and rewarded for that. To all of those that are in my same situation, I would say find some sort of emotional stability in Christ, because I was just all over the place, crying and reaching out to friends and family, which was good and they were helpful, but they're also human. And their anger and their expectations of what Daniel should have done play into their advice for me. So once I got clear direction from Christ, it was easy to put a handle on the anger and the bitterness and the resentment. Now, it's still there, and it still does creep up from time to time, but I think that's okay, and I think that's part of the process of deciding I'm going to love my husband, who has chosen not to be my husband until the end, but I'm also going to love and choose to love God. And this is what he's called me to do right now, is to honor my marriage vows. When I think of the future, I wonder a lot how it's all going to play out and what exactly my life's going to look like even a year down the road or 5 years down the road. I wonder what the boys are going to think. I wonder if God will provide another spiritual man in their life to fulfill a high expectation of a godly man that I want my two boys to grow up and to be like. And I think the verse that comes to mind would be Ephesians 3:20, that says, God will do more than we dare ask or imagine. And so that just gives me hope that he's working for me and for good, and I have no idea what's to come.